If Scat's got this, if the snake is well practiced and the snake is ready to go, this is going to be a real threat to Sam Sora's winner's bracket run here.
All right, and we're getting right on into it. This is going to be game number one, and this time now it is a best of five.
Actually, this is still the same round.
This is still the same round. All right,
yes,
Sam Sora versus Scat. Scat rocking the snake, not the Mega Man versus Sam Sora, that character classic Peach.
It looking, I don't know. He just doesn't seem like he's in the groove just yet, Scat. He's working his way in there, starting by camping. So far, has not got any damage on Sam Sora, despite using 8 grenades at this point. And Sam Sora's fine with that. It's like, all right, I'll just dance around these grenades, and gets the C4, almost gets the double C4 combo. Down air out of shield, gets a lot of damage there.
Sam Sora is so good at just maneuvering around these grenades so far. There have been grenades all over the map, as you said. Sam Sora is just like, no, I can float right on over them. I can get these turnip punishes.
Well, think how many active snake players there are. You know, Salem, MVD. There's so many good snake players right now out there playing Pelka. So Sam Sora is extremely experienced in this matchup. It's good. Scat's going to have to play not just by the numbers here, but incredibly smart to overcome this matchup, because Sam Sora is quite versed in it.
And Sam Sora has done so well at just keeping control of center stage, letting Scat set up only near the ledge, and then punishing him as he tries to get his projectiles game going. I mean, the juggling from Sam Sora has just been phenomenal so far. Scat opting to recover super high, but that early air dodge gets punished super hard by Sam Sora. Going all the way out there to finish off that stock.
Yeah, Scat had to got B early. I don't even know if Scat could have made it. He would have had the C4 tech the wall, but Sam Sora didn't even give him the opportunity to do so. Only 79% so far on Sam Sora, just sneaking around that up smash. That is incredibly good character knowledge. Sam Sora knows exactly when that up smash is going to come out, was able to dance around it without causing any trouble or giving up his position.
Yeah, it feels like he just knows exactly how far every explosive reaches. Good stuff there, holding onto it and just keeping his shield up as well.
And so far,
just dancing around the grenades, and he knew he was stuck, and he run in and shielded it and hit Scat with his own C4.
Yeah, I think the C4 blew up you blew up and hit him, and because of the shield box extended. But at any rate, Scat took a lot of damage from that one. And Sam Sora is not sweating it. Yeah, at 107, he just knows he can't get hit by the up tilt.
Or does he? Or he can just get hit by the up tilt. Comes down with the down air, thinking he can just, you know, go through it. And now he's actually, we were complimenting how good he was at avoiding the grenades. He just ate a ton of grenade damage. This game is basically even.
And it's basically right there. It's just funny how one up tilt changes the whole momentum, because Scat has not gotten hit on this stock so far since he took the last one. And he has made the game completely even.
I'm surprised he didn't go for back throw. He was looking for a follow-up. Nice turnaround up tilt. Not quite enough to kill, but it's getting real close to that percentage where Snake can just knock you out.
And now Scat is cooking. His Snake is oh my, he's going to read the roll right? No, he calls the down smash instead to cover the platform. Very, very smart.
But he had parried that. I feel like he could have just gone for parry up tilt.
That's what I was thinking, the same thing. But
maybe the spacing was just a little off, but it doesn't matter, as he's just going to get the back throw here, and Scat looking way more confident in this matchup all of a sudden.
Yeah, his Snake's cooking now. He's got warmed up. He said, all right, I know this is my secondary, but I'm ready to go.
And then he just side B's by accident.
I'm sorry, guys.
Whoops.
This is twice in the first game.
Well, Scat unfortunately throwing that stock away. It's now dead even on the last stock. I just love the projectiles flying back and forth behind between these guys. Sam Sora just super confident, runs in and grabs him.
Yeah, Sam Sora went for the big play. He was trying to call the jump, and if he called the jump, Snake was out of jump, he would have probably been able to finish the stock right there. Good play by Scat, knowing that call was coming. All right, matches out. Oh, good air dodge. Sam Sora could not cover it in time.
Yeah, phenomenal movement here from Scat, even in the disadvantage when he's knocked off stage. Oh, and a phenomenal time throwing him when the grenade exploded, making him take the extra damage, Scat taking nothing there.
And remember, you know, MVG, Salem plays Snake also, so he's got plenty of knowledge. You know, this didn't come out of nowhere, so Scat is playing excellently so far. The first stock looked a little rough, but he got his act together. It is a dead even contest here in game number one.
And while the percents might not look even, Snake can kill much earlier than Peach with that up tilt. Unless Peach can get a really solid fair, like right near the ledge. But Scat has not been falling for any of these strong kill moves. Oh, weird down B timing. And there's the nair near the ledge, and that's gonna do it.
Just barely, the nair gets the strong spot of the nair, and it does the job. So Sam Sora takes game number one, and it just felt like all Scat's momentum got lost when he SD'd on that second stock. He had had things going his way, and then unfortunate error. I think he was trying to grenade instead of a side B, and cost him.
Yeah, super unfortunate. Samsor going to take that first game. Now the question becomes, what is the counterpick going to be from Scat? And are we going to see the switch to Mega Man, or is he going to just stick it out with the Snake?
I don't think that went bad enough that he needs a switch. I think unless he's got like a counterpick that's going to work out for Mega Man, I don't think that was bad enough to switch. I think, he's thinking about it. I think the counterpick, if he's got a counterpick that's really solid for Mega Man in this matchup, he might go for it. But I think even if he does, even if he does have that in his pocket and he wins game two that way, he's still going to have to go back to the Snake game three. So he's going to have a game with Snake either way, I feel like. We're going to have a song pick here. Give us a good one.
That's a good one.
All right, that's a good one.
Elite Four music is always good. He's definitely thinking about it.
Right next to each other on the CSS, Snake and Mega Man.
All right, the Mega Man has been locked in. So character switch active. Can he do it with the Mega Man? What he couldn't do with the Snake as we're getting started on Kalos.
So this is, I think, the biggest stage. I think Pokemon Stadium and this stage are almost identical from a size perspective. So just the platform layout and the wall layout here. So Mega Man is one of the heaviest characters in the game. I think he's 9th or 10th heaviest. So this is a, what he's got to do is stay alive for a long time. He doesn't have to win the War of Attrition here. This is okay. He can take the early combos. As long as he doesn't give up that stock under 130, I think he's in good shape. But that's really that's when he's going to struggle in the matchup until then. He's just going to have to get the blows and get a Peach KO early.
And as you said earlier, he really needs to be keeping Peach out, finally hitting her with some of those hitboxes. But for the most part, as we saw in game one, Samsora is so good at just weaving around all the projectiles of his opponent.
Calls the forward air, and see, there's the heaviness of Mega Man coming into play there. 127%, not even close to losing his stock there. And there it is. So because projectiles are so hard to use in Smash 4, those pellets would have gone right through Peach's back air. In this game, the back air just eats all of them.
Yeah.
And that's
aerials from Peach are just so potent against these projectiles. That's what makes it so difficult for Mega Man.
And you can see Samsor is very knowledgeable about that. He's making a count. Back air, not going to do it. Mega Man again, very heavy.
Oh, but that's a stitch. Oh, he just throws it away. Assumed Mega Man was going to get up immediately.
And this is kind of where I thought the matchup might go. With a stage this big, Mega Man can live a long time, but gets to the neutral air. He was going for the up tilt. It looked like it was, I thought for a second he might have got it.
But that's another stitch in his hand. He's just pulled two in a row, and look at the damage. And
stock face.
Why is he doing this? He's pulled so many good turnips.
Peach mains, they have powers. Peach mains absolutely have powers.
They pull the craziest turnips in the perfect situations. And look at what he's doing. He's actually playing the item game right now better than Scat, because he's just whomping on him with these turnips. Gets in. He hasn't died. He's been sitting at 116. That was another dot eye. Forward air is going to be enough to do it, calling out the up B double jump.
And it is not looking good for Scat. This is extremely difficult to overcome because he can't win the War of Attrition. At this point, he's going to have to play untouchable.
And that's not something Mega Man likes to do.
No, not at all. So the forward air is not going to kill from center stage. Samsor, knowledgeable of this, he's just going to stay in the center stage, try to make Mega Man go for a commit. Because none of Mega Man's moves really KO at that point. I don't think this will KO. Nope, not at all. Palace League is a humongous stage.
But at least it was a great awareness by Scat, knowing he can wait for that spot dodge and get the punish on it. Oh, but this is super not good. Early grab. Scat already off stage. Great punishing here from Samsora, who's just keeping Scat on the ledge, not even letting him come back. Could this even potentially be a three stock? Even though he's at 173%, Samsora is just not letting Scat hit him.
And this was the key to the matchup. He had to get that Peach stock early if it's going to work on this stage. But instead, it's Peach that's living 192%. None of the Mega Man stocks thus far has been that long. So 203%, and the up air is what does the job.
Such a weird kill option. But hey, he takes what he can get. And look at the combo here from Scat.
Scat moving and grooving here.
And a great recovery from Scat as well. A super early up B dodges that forward air. keeping him alive. If that forward air had connected, he would definitely be dead right now.
Remember the big play? Tried to get the fast fall to auto-cancel to grab. Did not work out there. Scat on his winner's bracket tournament stock here, ResLived.
He's still playing phenomenally. He's finally starting to turn it on, but the problem is he's actually just one hit away from death, and he still has to take two stocks.
We could see an early stock with an up tilt, but I don't even think up tilt is going to be good enough just yet at 81.
Yeah, he's got to put on a little bit more percent. He's at least staying away from Peach. That's all he really needs to do. But Samsor perfectly happy to just wait this game out with a huge lead he has.
And Samsor is not going to give him the up tilt. He's been perfectly spacing those up airs so that even if he parried it and punished it with up tilt, it would be the sour spot. It wouldn't be the strong spot, and he could have got one there.
Yeah, he definitely had that read, but I think he just didn't believe in himself enough. If he had just gotten that up tilt, that would have been huge.
Try to call him jump in there. Oh! Wow! What a shield decision. That's able to get the job done. Scat will live this here. Tournament stock once again here for the winner's bracket of Scat.
Oh, but the get-up attack just immediately eaten by the back air of Samsora. Samsora turning up the pressure on the ledge to close out that game. Samsora looking super solid with a 2-0 over Scat.